I don't know what you think, but you might think the guy that is there is now standing on stage and maybe we finally hear something about thunder. Well, no, you don't. I will actually talk about open source and how we do it at Borda. And it will be very similar to what Buddy already said. So luckily, I can skip a few slides and we will... Can we have this in full screen? And we will go home early, hopefully. Let's see. Okay, open source. And specifically, how we do open source how we do open source at Borda, why we do it, and what's in for it for us. Why do we use open source? This is everything that Buddy said before. So I will condense it down to the one thing that was most relevant for us. It is to be independent in the end. Being independent of proprietary vendors, be independent of being locked to something that that we cannot really change. We can throw money at it, but we can hope for the best. It boils down to, with open source, you can choose when and how often you implement your features. You can go to different integrators. They can all help you with it. You can build your own stuff that will implement the stuff you need, and you have it. You don't have to wait for some vendor to do it for you or to do it at all. And you don't depend on it as much, especially when you're like Borda and you might have, I don't know, 20 sites or 30 sites with locked in with one vendor, and that vendor decides to do something completely crazy, then it's not so nice. Coasts. Buddy also talked about that a bit. I'm not sure, using open source, if this really is helping you with coasts. Yes, it's cheaper, you have no license fees, but you still have to implement stuff. You still have to pay your developers, you have to pay an integrator, you have to pay someone to do the stuff that you really want, if it's not, at least if you have a bit more needs than just installing Thunder and it's fine. So coasts, I don't know, at least not yet. But why do we create open source? This is something completely different. It's creating open source is you just don't use it. You create something and give it to everybody. And this everybody is, for example, your competitor. And this brings us back to the very first speech we had yesterday, back to Ingo. In his speech he said, you know, we are all quite nice companies, but compared to the really big companies, we are small. And he said it with data, if we use all the same data, if we open the data and work all together, then we can compete with the big data companies as Google and Amazon and Facebook. He said probably exactly the same thing 3 years ago to me. That's when we decided to open source Thunder. He said, how can we compete against Facebook? Yes, we're Borda, we are not a small company, but still, we're not a tech company, and we do stuff that is completely different, but there are other companies like us that do the exact same stuff, have the exact same challenge, and do it for themselves. So why don't we go together and try to be more than just our small companies, or bigger companies, but small compared to Google, compared to Facebook especially, and just concentrate on what we do, on creating content, having good articles, and all that stuff that we actually do. So we decided we have to do this open and we have to go to our competitors, we have to go to other people and say, let's do it together or we will not be able because we are no tech companies, but we still need the tech. How did we do this in the end? First, of course, you have to decide it. Yeah, you have to decide, just do it. It seems easy, but it's kind of strange because you have, suddenly, I'm not an open source person before. I wasn't. I didn't create open source. I used open source, but I didn't create it. So for me, it was actually quite different or difficult even to say, OK, I put down my pants and put it on a website, and everyone can download what I did and can take a look at it and can criticize it and can say, well, you are stupid. Yeah, yeah, but that's it. You have to do it, and you have to just decide to do it. And this is the first step. The next step was that we invited the others. So you can't just say, okay, we create this, we give it to the world, and but you, what you want is you want something back. And if you want to have that, then you have to talk with those people. You have to go to first the coworkers, so they also have to. Give their stuff away. They also have to pay money to their developers, to their system integrators, and then open sources. This is not easy to communicate. And then you have to go to your competitors, actually, and say, this is our idea, and why not do this? So this was the second thing we did, and that this is still going on. So this is the reason why we're here, basically. And then we decided to create a dedicated team for that project. And I think this was the most important step. When you create a project, at least a web-based content management system, and you try to do it within your existing projects, within your daily business, then this will not succeed. We tried it before, actually, and it is really hard because you have to you are not as fast as you need to be in the actual business, but and you are not as as strict as you need to be for a real product. So we decided to get a dedicated team that gets paid for doing nothing else than open source. Next step was participate in other open source projects. This is also very, very important. If you want to gain from using and creating open source, you have to start to participate with other open source projects, especially for us with Drupal, of course, which is our base. If you do that, then you get back. Otherwise, you don't. So people don't know you, people don't care about you. But if you participate and you really invest in your basis, in Drupal core, in the modules that you use, in everything that everyone else has done for you, then they recognize that and they see, okay, they mean business, so we can help. Last thing, or in between all of this, was building a community. This is part of this. This is the integrators that we certify, that work with us, that work with people that use Thunder. This is being part of the bigger community of Drupal itself, which is, of course, much bigger than we would be right now. So this is also very important, because otherwise you cannot communicate further. Optional, pay a Drupal core developer. Yeah, we pay a Drupal core developer to do his work. Of course, we kind of nudge him to the problems that we have a bit, but he's quite free on his decisions to make. But this is really helpful, especially this year. It was really helpful. I said it yesterday. That helped us reduce our technical debt a lot. And it is also a kind of, yeah, helps also in the recognition part. What did we gain out of this? This is a larger wall of text. This was the very first thing that happened. Actually, the first person that I communicated with is somewhere here, I hope. It's Alexander Lee. Alexander, still here? Gone? I don't know. He's the developer of Playboy DE. And he was not a Drupal developer at that time. And when we started with Thunder, we decided, okay, we have several developers within Borda, and I don't know them. I really don't. Some of them I did because I worked with them together, others from other departments, from other cities, I've never seen, and we have never exchanged knowledge. So I went to Playboy, the CTO of Playboy, and we proposed that we do the relaunch of Playboy DE together as the initial, it wasn't called Thunder back then, but as the initial distribution. And together with Alexander, we were kind of the alpha team that created the alpha version of Thunder. And since then, he got a Drupal developer. We learned from each other and put other people, other developers into that room, and now we are communicating, which was not the case before. And now we share knowledge in the company. It has nothing to do with open source in the end, but still, this is the first outcome of it. Then it improved the product. If you open source and you put it out there, people talk back. They have feature requests. We talk to hundreds, literally hundreds of publishers in Germany, in Switzerland, in Austria, and some outside. And they all have ideas. And collecting them and aggregating them was very, very, very important. You get bug reports. People use it, and they create bugs and find bugs that we wouldn't, because they do different stuff with it. And it's fixing those bugs improves, of course, the product. And they do code reviews. That's maybe sounds a bit technical, but it's very important. You get an opinion of some knowledgeable people about what you did and how to improve it. Maybe they have ideas to do it better. And maybe even say it's crap and here is a better solution. That's all very nice for the product itself. In the end, the product gets more reusable. This is also something that Buddy mentioned at least a bit. It's very important, actually. At first, Thunder was not reusable. It was there, but we struggled with being able to really create very independent projects. It was fine within some limits, but what we really learned when we put it out in the open was, yeah, it's nice, and it's somewhere there in the border context might be okay, but it's very restrictive, and we had to start working on that, and that helped us again in future projects to be quicker, because the product was not as opinionated and restricted as it was before. So that helped. We wouldn't have learned later, probably, but sooner is better. Then it distributes work. Of course, this is probably the basic idea that you have from open source. Yeah, you get people to fix your bugs, which happened. I can still remember the first time some bug was fixed from someone I never heard. It was quite amazing. And you also get implemented features. You get to use ready modules, modules that are production ready and that you can just add. You have to, don't have to do anything about that. You have also, very important, last part is very important, we have many, many maintenance costs, of course, because the more you create yourself, the more you have to maintain. But if you share, people can chip in and maintain stuff for you. Or you improve the stuff that others already maintain and just make it, just get it, just don't get it into your code base at all. So this is all. This is the point where I think the money comes into place, not by using open source, by creating open source and by helping others create the open source that you use. So because then you get all those savings from just distribution of work and product. Yes, that's the last point. So your dependencies if you improve your dependencies, if you improve Drupal core, if we improve Drupal core, if we improve modules that are not in a shape that we hope they would be, they are also improved. You have to work on that. If you just wait that somebody does it, as you would do with a proprietary system, then you are out of luck. But you can actually do it. And then it's done. This is also something that is very important. By doing open source, you make your developers happy. For several reasons, I think. One of the reasons is simply, you know, it's nice to be recognized. Yeah, if you do a project just for your company, for your brand, it's also nice to be recognized there, and your project manager or your boss says, well done. But if you put something out, and there are thousands of people downloading it and using it and thinking that it's great, it's fantastic for a developer. And it's almost a competition which module of the developers has the more downloads nowadays, or who has more commits to core or something like that. So this is very, very nice. You don't get it otherwise. Then, yes. Yeah, it's the same. Why did I? Ah, oh no. This is this, what I just said. The first was something else. Just remember that I changed the order. Okay, this is that. The first thing was that that you get to do things that you wouldn't do in projects. Because you can go deep, you can dig deep. You, at least if you do it as we do, with a separate team that is dedicated to that, you can do the stuff much more better, just much better, and much more deep into the technology base to do it correct. This is something that you cannot do often in projects when, at least if the project is not the product itself. So if you are building a website and you try to improve the content management system by doing some workarounds just to have it, then it's, you know, it's for your project, it's fine, but it's not satisfying to do that workaround. So yeah. This is at least it depends on the developer. Some developers don't care about that, but other developers say, "Okay, nice, I can do it correctly." And this is something that not only developers can enjoy, but whenever you go to a big Drupal convention, to DrupalCon or Drupal Dev Days, you actually see it's a very, very nice and very, very friendly community. This is a Drupal thing, I think, because there are other open source communities that are not that nice and friendly. But in Drupal, it is actually true. You go there and you work together again. People go there. You know, imagine you're a week on at the DrupalCon, and you get paid from your employer for being there, but everyone there, or at least many people there, just sit there the whole day and fix bugs in Drupal core or somewhere else, just like that, and help each other and talk to each other, and you know, talking to other people is, you know, this is the bad thing of being in this as a developer, you know, you have to stand on stages like this, and but it's nice to actually can talk to people, to a lot of people that are quite similar to you. This is, for a developer, this is important. And it's kind of cool. It's kind of the resolution of that whole slide. It is easier, and Buddy mentioned it, it is easier to convince good developers to work for you if you do something cool. And for a lot of developers, it is something cool to do open source. This is not, we still had to look months for getting developers, but it was easier than before. So this is really nice. This is also something that companies should care about. Care about your developers. We are the horses that do this stuff. And when we are lucky and when we like our work, it's not bad. It really is not bad. So, and as I promised, that's it. Not too much.
Any questions to Daniel? Thunder Daniel, Thunder Bosen. No, I think we have the possibility to talk after the...
Of course. Now Kai might come up again.
You have a question or do you want to...
He wants to talk something. I think he wants to say thank you to the nice people.
Okay. I wanted to... Should I wait for Kai?
I just wanted to thank you, everybody, and especially... to have the organizing team, Galina, Christina, and Carlo come up here. I have a big thank you for them.
Come on, it's your stage.
The light.
Come out, please. Yay.
Thank you very much.
You can all come out.
So I saw there are presents. Actually, I was thinking this morning that I would buy some flowers, but then I remembered we are all flying back, so I thought I would rather buy the flowers tomorrow. So imagine the flowers now, and instead you get...
Yeah, so we at the other part of the team just acknowledged the work those three guys just did over the last weeks and make this great conference happen. And so we decided in first place to give a little present today and didn't inform Kai about this. So sorry for that.
No problem.
So what I wanted to say, sorry.
Just before you say that, there's another part of the team, of our CTO team, and they all helped together today to make this happen and yesterday. So thank you very much, everybody, too. And of course, to you all.
Yay.
All of you in the audience, you contributed, you paid fees that help us make this event happen. We are still sponsoring a great deal of this event, but it makes it much more easier if you put a little part in it as well.
Yeah, so this was the second, and I'm pretty sure it won't have been the last Thunder Day.
So we will, to add here, we will come back to all of you in the next... days or weeks, probably, and we'll do a survey of how you liked it here and what we can do better, and also some ideas you might have about Thunder in general that we can adopt for next year and for our product roadmap.
That's what I wanted to say. If you liked what you heard and saw and felt in these 2 days, share it to your community as Alexander Barbing did. Alexander Barbing, where are you? Can you? Yeah, he was the most active Twitterer with the hashtag ThunderDay 2018. I think these guys appreciate that. And if you didn't like it, also share it. Share it to those girls and guys that they can improvable things. And the worst thing you can do is not to talk about your experiences here, because remember, only shareable data is good data. And thank you for you making it possible.
Thanks.
See you next year.